My role was, I'm based at Golden Square Primary School, and I was approached by La Trobe to go into the university and work with the lecturers. And I was introduced to Jim, and I spent 1 day a week with going to lectures and finding out what the particle model was all about and how chemistry fit in and what he was teaching in his with his students. And then Jim came up with these ideas about the particle model, and he said, what is the best way to represent that? And we went down the track of using stop motion software, and that's what the large part of this experience has been about with the students.
Can I look at your pivot, back at the pivot one? So what are you doing with these two stick figures?
Well, that's just, they're just the people that are going into the hot air balloon.
Okay.
When we're animating it.
The particle model has allowed us to probably look at science in a different way. To look at that table and think of it as a whole lot of little balls that are moving around. Initially, the students didn't get it. To break it up and then actually put it into counters and they're manipulating those counters around, it started to make a connection with them. So it was really powerful. And now I think where the students are up to is that they're representing that in a model, and that's where the animations fit in with their stop motion.
Okay, just show me quickly what you're, so you can do some shots. And just to imagine that we've got some particles over here. I'm gonna put your hand there, maybe, and we'll just, grab.
That's all right, that's fine.
Yes.
So from the perspective of the school students here, the pedagogical focus on them representing their understandings and having authorship through the creation of these animations via the technology has kind of hopefully allowed them to see science as perhaps being less a rhetoric of conclusion, you know, the focus is the idea that science is dead in a lot of the ways that it's taught, that it's a pre-made thing and the students have no way of really interacting with that knowledge. So through actually becoming authors and using science as a tool, rather than just taking it receptively, they've hopefully had some insight into the collaborative nature of modern science.
Well, at the top, there's all the clear particles. So
is this the spray can?
Yes.
Okay.
Little clear particles up at the top.
So collaboration was a really important aspect of the whole thing, and they actually, the students not only collaborated within the class, they also collaborated online with Web 2 technology, which was blogs and wikis. They were able to give each other feedback, and the student teachers were also able to go into those and actually add feedback as well. So there was this collective knowledge that was happening through the whole time.
That looks like a wave to me.
Yeah, it looks like a perfect wave. I just need some sand.
Just also to make it a little
fill
bit...
Fill bucket.
Now, fill bucket. Yellow.
So did Steve talk about how many frames you'd need?
Five.
Yeah.
He done five for his.
Yeah, you don't want to make it too... Otherwise you've got to do too many shots. And it'll take your animation forever to do. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. So here you go.
Thank you, Mr. Jasmine.
Thank you.
Well done.
How would Karina be acting if she's a salt? What properties does a salt particle have? Yes, Will. What would she be doing?
It's solid and she'd be tight, like all squeezed together.
Yep, tightly bonded. What can she move?
When we took it into the Golden Square School, one of the aspects that came through was that the students themselves were able to straight away, they actually came across some of the challenges with technology, which was one of the first things that we found. They'd been introduced at the university level and we used the sort of technology, the iPads and that, which they felt really comfortable with, was something that they were familiar with, they were using all the time. Then when we took it into the school setting, the students were confronted with some technology that was a little bit older. And so that was one of their first challenges. And one of the, probably my role was to reinforce with students that that's normal with technology. The strength of the group that we've just had that have gone through this practicum is how they've worked and bonded together. So they've had their individual strengths in their teaching, and they've been able to share those strengths with each other. And we had one example where one of the groups was just grappling a little bit with trying to utilise this older technology, and we actually crossed over, so some of the support from the other students came across, and I think that that's a really, really good model in our teaching.
Yeah.